payasos.
This video is for mature audiences. If you're watching this and you're underage, you have shitty parents or parent and they should be sterilized.
Well, hola. This is your boy Tika Trin, and something I always found funny about the Western world and society is the whole entire dating thing and the thing that women do to try to make it so that they seem more appealing. And like, especially with the going to school thing, unfortunately, men aren't looking for women who go to school. They don't want a woman that they have to compete with. It's just facts. The thing about that is what women don't realize is they're trying to do shit. They're trying to fit men into something that they believe or desire themselves. If you see what I'm saying. Because the thing about it is what women don't realize is men don't look at the same values in women that women look for in men. It's just facts. This is where women always get it wrong, or they always try to pass the blame. The fact of the matter is they don't want to see the fact that men don't think and approach the same way women do, or look at relationships in the same light that women do in this day and age. So a woman who has her bachelor's and shit like that is not going to be seen as high value to a man who has his bachelor's or his master's. It's just facts. She's not seen as high value. The problem with that is what women fail to realize in this day and age is that men, the more education a man gets, the more his options open. The more education a woman gets, the lesser her options are, for the most part. That's the best way I can put it to you. The more educated a man is, the more his options open up for him. The more educated a woman is, the more her options close on her. So a man with more education has more options. A woman with more education has less options. It's just the nature of the beast, and it's just facts. Because at the end of the day, what a man desires in a woman isn't the same thing a woman desires in a man. And women always miss the mark on this. And it's sad, but a lot of women are missing out on this, and they think because, and I really don't blame women for believing this, because they get caught up in this whole entire feminism and all this other bullshit and this unicorns and rainbows shit. So they believe that because they desire men like this, men should desire women like them, which is not the case at all. Because at the end of the day, what you fail to realize psychologically is, a man, first off, doesn't want to have to compete with his significant other, first off. First and foremost, that's just it. Secondly, a man wants a woman who is a family-oriented woman, who can take care and provide and keep the family safe, and keep it safe, healthy, and keep them fed for the most part. That's what a man wants. In this day and age, it probably doesn't matter if you actually feed him or not. As long as you feed the children and they grow up big and strong and you care for the house, that's all that matters to that man. That's the cold hard truth. Like, a man's not going to pick a woman who's going to be outside the house. I mean, granted, there's going to be some shit that happens. Like, every now and again, in a blue moon, that shit will happen. But the chances of that happen are very slim to none. It's very slim to none. And the sad part about it is, like, I don't date white women, but the chances of, a white woman has a better chance of actually being in a relationship with me than a woman who's educated has a better chance of actually being in a relationship with a woman. I mean, with a man. I mean, a woman that's educated has a chance of being in a relationship with a man who's educated or more educated or just as educated as her. That's just facts. And the sad part about that is, like, the chances of me dating a woman is, like, less than the chances of you winning a lottery. So, the chances of you actually meeting a man who is just as educated, if not more educated than you, or the statistics of you actually dating me. And that's just it. Like, I highly doubt that it'll ever happen. Unless you drug me and, like, take advantage of me, which I highly doubt you will. because you're not stupid. And that's just it. Like, women don't realize this shit. And when they realize it too late. Then they already missed their window of opportunity. And it's funny how, like, we always talk about this dream where, like, you know, women, if they pursue their careers, they can always go back and have a family. No, that's not always the case. Unfortunately, your prime years for actually having babies is about, 16 to about 24, 25 is your prime years for having babies. Anything after that, for the most part, anything after 25, 26 to 28 starts being the yellow area. I mean, the pretty much starts being the yellow area. Anything after that ends up being the red area. It's just facts. Because there's a whole lot of health implications that come with that after 30 and up, for the most part. I mean, don't get me wrong, 29 can be considered yellow, but, like, 29 would be considered yellow-red, for the most part. If you took yellow and red and put them together, you would get, like, an orange color. So you would be in the orange at that point in time when you're 29. 30, you'll start being in the red, and it gets more red, and it gets to the point where, like, you know, you ain't got no more eggs left to actually produce, and you'll end up, like, needing a surrogate of some sort, basically. And that's it. Or you'll end up having an egg freezing party, which is actually pretty funny to the fact that all these places are actually making a killing off these women for storing their eggs. And the sad part about it, the chance of them actually having a baby, even with their eggs being stored and frozen, are still very low. It's just facts. It's sad, but it's true. And people think that all this stuff is great. And they can do all this great stuff to do all this stuff to prolong stuff. But the fact of the matter is, all this shit is just like plastic surgery. It eventually wears. And you eventually have to go back and get it done over and over and over and over again. Because your body's still aging. And this is where a lot of people mess up. Like, especially with plastic surgery. If you get plastic surgery young and you didn't age yet, you're going to look horrible when you get older. I mean, it's bad enough that, I mean, when women do it later in their lives, they actually look a lot better because they tend to do it they tend to be smart enough to do it much more subtle when they're in their later years. Whereas when they're younger, they go above and beyond what they actually need. And the more they age, the worse they look. It's just facts. Hell. It sucks, but it's truth. And this is the thing that I've always... This is the thing that, like, what women don't realize. Like, your window of opportunity is closing. And if not, it is closed. But because you bought into a notion, you let it blow by. It sucks when you see a lot of women who are in their 30s and still single. I mean, it's funny, but it sucks when you see a lot of women in their 30s and are still single. And they haven't had any family yet. And they're sitting there looking like, I don't understand why no man wants me. Well, the fact of the matter is, those men that you were trying to get that were as educated as you, if not more educated than you, have already picked their women and they've already had their children and are already happy. It's just facts. The ship's already sailed on your ass. And the men that you were looking for has already picked their women and already had their pretty much feeling they have a house full of children and a lovely wife for the most part. I mean, I'm not going to say she's very lovely, but for the most part, most men who actually do that and women who actually don't go to school, they tend to have longer, much more fulfilling relationships for the most part than women who actually go to school and try to get married. The relationships end up being very short-lived, which is actually fun and funny. But yeah, that's the problem with society. Women believe that men think the same way that they do, and they deserve to have this because this is what a man should want, when in fact, a man wants what he wants, but it's wrong for him to want what he want, and he should want you because you're as educated as him, when in fact, that's not his goals, nor is it his priority, nor is it his thing. He doesn't want a woman that's as educated as him. He wants a woman who can provide a safe haven in a home, in a happy home, in a healthy home for children. That's what a man wants. I know what you've been told But unfortunately, it's a false narrative, and it sucks. It sucks when you got to eat that pill. It's a false narrative that you've been fed. A man wants a woman that can provide a healthy, safe environment for a family. That's all it is. And I don't mean like as far as working. I mean as far as like home life. He wants a woman that can provide a happy, safe, and well taken care of, well maintained castle for the most part. Instead of a white woman who wants to slay dragons and come back. Because at the end of the day, think about it. Who's taking care of the children while you're gone? Can you really trust that person taking care of your children? Are your children really safe? Think about these things. Because at the end of the day, that's how a man views it. That's a man views things logically and strategically. If his children aren't with their mother, that's one more thing he has to worry about. If his children aren't with their mother, now he's worried about his children. It's just facts. That's how it works. But I digress.